kind of going back looking at the film, we think the moving key in the second half wasn't to that support.
They're tough to guard, man, between Kyrie and Luka and them coming downhill and pick and rolls. It's just tough to guard, and they're probably the two best guys in the league at doing that. They space the floor really well, so our help side has to be stronger, and transition, we got caught up a few times where, you know, we put ourselves in a good position to win that game, and then those guys took over at the end. They're great players, but before that, there was a couple spots where we just had mental errors and they made us pay, and a lot of things were in our control, you know. We could have won that game, and something we got to learn from.
How honest to see a team in the second game of the season that you've already seen two times? I know it's different lineups and things like that, but it seems like it's a...
It is what it is. The nice thing is we know what they play like. You know, we know their play style. We know what worked against them the first two times, so we'll just use that to our advantage.
Zach, what jumped out at you watching that video of the opener that you guys could do better, especially in getting Wimby the ball down low and the spots that he likes?
I don't know. I think... we can do a better job of recognizing the hot hand, whoever that is. Obviously, Wimby did a good job in the fourth quarter. Hit some big shots, had a couple, had an and one, big and one. A lot of momentum shifting. And then the last minute and a half, 2 minutes, our offense kind of struggled. You know, we were out of sorts a little bit. There was one play where we should have got into it a lot quicker, but everyone was walking to their spots. And that's just something that, you know, we got to get better at. And, you know, in preseason, we weren't really in those positions in the fourth quarter. You know, that was really our first rep of the fourth quarter, trying to win a game, you know, since being together. So we just got to learn from it. We'll be all right.
Do you think Victor, like every rookie, is going to have to adjust to how the game is officiated?
Yeah, it seems like the moving screens is even watching the games last night, it seems like it's a big emphasis this year. So. He got caught up in a couple. I got caught up in one that, you know. He'll be all right. I mean, there's going to be tough calls. You know, I don't think the refs are used to seeing a guy that tall and that big be able to cover ground and, like, move like that. So that's something they got to get used to as well.
They're going to have to adjust, too, because.
Yeah, something they've never seen before.
Some of these that look like fouls.
For sure. Yeah, they'll adjust, and he'll be all right.
What is it like watching them? You just had a pretty workout after Chiron is still watching, still being here, getting this kind of workout. And you've said it before, you know, he works his tail off every day, but what's it like seeing him putting in this kind of work?
Yeah, I mean, he's been doing that all summer. Since summer league, obviously, he's gotten a lot better. And being here in September, just seeing him work out every day, you know, he goes hard. He loves doing it. So he's got a great work ethic for sure.
Hi, Zach. We can see you're a veteran in this team. What are the things since you've been there for last few years in the NBA, what are the kind of things that you can say to a guy, 19, after a game like this? Are there encouraging words that you said to him, or some things, tips that you have as a veteran in the NBA?
Best thing about the NBA is there's always one the next night. There's always another one. We got 81 more of these things at least. So, you know, we just, especially for a young guy, I mean, go out there and not be afraid to make mistakes, and he's not. So he's very mature for his age, and he'll be okay no matter, you know, ups and downs. He'll be fine. And all I can do is just give him confidence and keep doing his thing.
Zach, as much as every season opener comes with, you know, anticipation, this one on Wednesday came with a little bit more. Is it good to just get that out of the way? Is there kind of a sense of, okay, now we can get back to a little bit of a sense of normalcy now that first game is out of the way?
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be normal all year, to be honest. But we have a lot of expectations on us this year, and the last couple of years have been tough. So the atmosphere is just going to be different all year than I think we're all used to. So we're looking forward to it. That first game was crazy. It felt like a playoff game with all the shirts and everything, shoot around, all the media coverage. It was fun.
You guys go to L.A. next. I don't think that's going to be normal.
LA is going to be crazy. Phoenix, I know we got coming up too. That's going to be crazy. You know, high profile names on both sides. It's going to be a lot of fun.
New York next week.
Hit some good spots for sure early in the season. I like it.
Devin worked a little bit with KD. Mm-hmm. You guys are going out to Phoenix. Mm-hmm. What does it do, you know, to work with a great like that? Anytime you're, you know, rubbing elbows and, you know, even Manu and just, mm-hmm. just absorbing things from those kind of guys.
It's a Hall of Fame guys, man. You know, what they did to not only just be great at what they do, but to do it for a long time. Win a lot of games, win championships. Those are champions. You know, you can learn so much from those guys, even if it's not from a skill standpoint. It's from how to be a professional, how to carry yourself, how to play 48 minutes, which a lot of young guys struggle with. No, it's big time, man. Anytime you can learn from those greats, it's huge.
A lot of people describe you as the enforcer of the team. You know, the top guy. So, did you embrace that role, and do you feel like it's an accurate description?
I mean, I don't know if I'm an enforcer. I just try to go out there and react to how the situation is. I mean, if it calls for having my guys back, I'll always be there. If it calls for me to calm down a little bit, I'll try to do that too. Probably won't be successful, but yeah, man, I'm just trying to be there for my guys and bring some physicality to the game, bring some toughness, set the tone, make sure that defensively we're locked in, and go from there.
Do you feel that you have to protect, the young guys like Wemby?
Yeah, but I mean, nothing's going to happen on the court usually. I mean, if somebody's going to talk to him, somebody's going to get in his face, and we're all ready for that. You know, we got a great chemistry, 1 through 15, so we all got each other's back for sure.
In terms of tonight, Zach, I know it's early, but, you know, from what you know about him, you see comparisons with you guys, the young core, you know, things along those lines. Just wondering if you kind of see anything that's kind of similar between you and them.
Yeah, They've got some guys that have been there for 3 or 4 years, kind of like we have. They're trying to build something over there with young guys and trying to incorporate some vets into that. I'd say we're a lot younger overall than they are. And we're really, really building from the ground up here. And both two young teams trying to get back to the top for sure.
How did you find the atmosphere with the fans Wednesday night? Was it different from last year?
Yeah, for sure. It was a lot different. Like I said, it kind of felt like a playoff game, and the buzz in there, the anticipation, it was a lot of fun to play on an opening night like that. And obviously, on top of that, we know how many people are watching at home on TV, so it was a big moment for sure.
Thanks, Zach.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.